So ولا نساء من نسائن عسى أن يكون خيرا منهن. Maybe that, you know, they're better, the ones being made fun of are better than the ones that are poking fun of them. Then he says, ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم. The ayah, this is all one ayah. All one ayah about not violating the rights of your tongue, this beautiful thing Allah has given you. ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم. Lamz in Arabic, you know, it could be قد يكون بالإشارة. It's poking, it's criticizing someone either by means of a bodily gesture or by means of your eyes, like rolling your eyes or sighing, taking a deep breath, or by a snicker or a comment made under your breath. This is not my definition. This is like ancient lexicons. The Sound al-Arab is telling us what lamaz means. To make snickering comments about someone that are under your breath, just so they heard you said something, but they don't quite know what you said. And when you ask them, what? Nothing. I didn't say anything. Right? That subtle kind of criticism and undermining somebody's speech, or demeaning someone, or being condescending towards someone, that's not even captured in speech. Sometimes you can insult someone without saying a single word. And Allah knows that. So He uses the word, وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. And because the ayah is talking about believers, you know what's amazing? Of the many things that are amazing about this ayah, He says, He doesn't say, don't make this kind of, you know, sarcastic, condescending, critical type of gesture to others. He said, anfusakum, to yourselves. In other words, when you do this to another believer, they are you, you are them, you're one people, you're one nation. So who are you really making fun of? It's actually your own self. And the other implication here is, when someone does this kind of thing, the only one they're really successfully insulting is their own dignity. The only one they're really harming is their own sense of self-worth. وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. It's a very powerful statement. Don't do it. Allahu A'lam. I would even add, among the secret gestures nowadays is to send somebody a text message about how stupid somebody else sounds, or how, you know, how ugly they look, or take a picture and just post it up on a social networking site about how ridiculous somebody are. Just an act of embarrassing them. So the ancient time, the act of embarrassing someone could have been the gesture with a hand, or with the rolling of an eye, or just a, you know, deep breath, or some remark spread about them. But now it takes modern forms. Just because it's taken a modern form doesn't make it permissible. It's the same crime. So وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Then he says, وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. And don't call each other out by nicknames. And نَبَزَ is used in Arabic, this is the larger form of the word, but it's to try to come up with artificial nicknames against each other that you're trying to make them stick on them. So you're trying to make sure everybody around calls them that. And they themselves are hurt and insulted by it. Now what happens when you call somebody else a nickname? In response, they'll call you a nickname, right? They'll come up with something for you. And obviously they're doing that as an act of retaliation, even though you're just friends and you don't think it's a big deal. Some kind of animosity has been planted inside the heart. There's some offense that's taken. And you know when that's really going to come out? Maybe it won't come out now. Maybe your friend doesn't want things to get ugly between you, so he or she doesn't say anything when you call them a nasty nickname or an insulting nickname, commenting about their weight or their height or their skin color or their accent or whatever it may be, you know, or their intelligence even. But it will come out on Judgment Day. When that person is in a deficiency of good deeds and they could use whatever they can get, they'll come after their best friend and say, "You used to call me this nasty nickname. And for every time he called me this nickname, I'd like to get compensated. So why doesn't he or she take some of these sins of mine for every time they use that word against me?" And how much, you know, they might make that kind of deal. Watch out. Because they're friends with you now. We're friends now. That's not the case on Judgment Day. When a mother forgets her child, you're not going to remember your friends. The day Allah describes, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ, the day in which a person runs away from his own brother, وَصَاحِبَتِهِ, you know, His wife he runs away from, that he was lived with forever and ever, he would never get away from her, he loved her, he's running away from her on Judgment Day. What do you think, your friends are going to care that day? That this might hurt your feelings, or they wouldn't want to take away from your good deeds? Nowadays you say, "I don't want to say anything, it might hurt his feelings." On that day you're not going to care about anybody's feelings but your own. So watch out from making those kinds of offensive comments and those kinds of offensive gestures. وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. Don't call each other by nicknames. بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ. The ayah just keeps dropping treasure after treasure. It's all one ayah. He says, الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ. The horribly, the inherently corrupt word. The word ism really means noun or name. The word, the corrupt word itself is utterly despicable. بِئْسَ, how terrible it is. بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ, after you have faith. In other words, when a person has iman, then bad language which all of this was describing was bad language. And on top of this, by using بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ, Allah is even now including cuss words and foul language. You know, filthy language. What all of this together, this kind of language, Allah says, how terrible can this be? This is an absolutely nasty thing to have once you have iman. Once faith is there. You know what that suggests? If you're a person and I'm a person, that we don't care if we curse. It just rolls off our tongue. And we don't care if we make snickering comments about someone. And filthy language, whether spelled out exactly as the bleeped out word is, or you make a variation of the spelling and say, no, I didn't use the bad word, I used a closely spelled word that sounds like it, to play word games like that, even though your intent is clearly known, then you know what that suggests? That faith isn't there. Because once iman is there, these things are ugly to you, despicable to you. You wouldn't even want to go near them. بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ. And at the end of this, if you realize maybe my faith is being hurt, maybe I haven't cried in salah forever and ever, and I haven't really remembered Allah or thanked Him, and maybe you realize that your real disease is nothing but your lack of controlling your tongue. The more filthy words you use, the blacker your heart gets. And so you can't remember Allah clear, you know, in a healthy way. Maybe if you realize that now, then now would be the time you make tawbah. Now immediately would be the time, I'm not going to do this again. I'm going to watch my tongue. I'm going to become a better person. So Allah says about the end of this ayah. So and what an amazing way to end this ayah. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُوبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. And whoever didn't repent, then those are the wrongdoers in fact. Those in fact are the wrongdoers. In other words, if you come to this point of the ayah, where once you have faith, these things should be terrible to you already, and you realize that this is a detriment to your faith itself, the natural consequence of that should be you repenting and walking away from these things and apologizing to Allah and to those you've offended. This is part of your tawbah. And if you fail to do so, then the only kind of people who would fail to do so are people who don't value their iman. They don't have value for their faith. So what should they be called if not dhalimun, wrongdoers? They are the ultimate wrongdoers. They didn't realize the weight of that crime. I pray that I and you are able to watch our tongues in public and in private, and are able to stay away from offensive comments and remarks, and are able to say things that actually cause, you know, love and unity and courtesy among each other, and our words don't become a means of just building ill feelings towards each other now, and especially inshallah it doesn't come out in its nasty form on Judgment Day. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikr al-Hakim. Keep up the good work, Qur'an Weekly. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.